Okay guys, so we are in a Beech 1900C. I got the GPS up here. The flight plan is loaded in. Let's get rid of the GPS. Let's zoom in on our HSI. There is the nav button. We're gonna put the HSI in the GPS mode. Now it's in the GPS mode. Now it's in the VOR mode. Let's put it back in the GPS mode because that's what we need. And let's immediately put in a heading of 183. Remember, we need to fly a heading of 183 to the point Driffy. Putting our flight path headings is going to be a lot more important with HSI. So the reason being is because the needle is located right on the heading indicator. So it can get very confusing if you leave the needle pointing to a heading of 300 and your flight path is 183. The needle will stay centered because no matter what you put on a heading bug on this HSI, the needle will stay centered as long as you're on the flight path. But it's really strange to be heading of 183 and to have the needle stay centered while it's pointing to a heading of 300. I'll demonstrate this better once we're up in the air. Okay, let's rotate. Positive rate of climb. Let's tap on the brakes. Landing gear up. And let's take a look at the HSI. Immediately after takeoff, the HSI needle is moving because we're moving away from our flight path. Same as in a VOR. The needle on a HSI in the GPS mode will show us the distance we are away from our flight path. Let's start our turn on to crosswind. Okay, let's reduce the torque down to about 32 for the Beech 1900C during a climb. Let's take a look off to our left. Okay, it's clear. Let's roll right back into our downwind. Okay, so as we're turning onto the left downwind to intercept our flight path, you're going to see that the needle is going to start to move in. And this is a fast airplane, well, faster than the Cessna 182. So that needle is going to start coming in pretty fast. So we have to be on our toes. Okay, there's the airport. The needle is close enough. Let's immediately turn onto a heading of 183 to intercept the flight path to our first point, Driffy. Once I'm established on that 183 heading to the point Driffy and the needle is centered, I'll bring up the GPS so we can take a look at how close we are to the flight path. One thing you have to notice with these HSIs and VORs is that because they give you a full deflection of about 5 miles, 0.2, 0.3 miles away from the flight path will not be a very big deflection on the needle. Okay, let's bring up the GPS. Let's zoom it in. And we're 0.18 miles away from the flight path, which is good. That is good. Like I said, the deflection on the needle at a 0.18, 0.15 miles will not be very noticeable on the HSIs and on the VORs. So we're heading to our point Driffy. Let's Let's concentrate on the GPS for just a second. The GPS will automatically update us to our next flight leg in a few seconds. And as soon as it does, let's see what happens. There it goes. Look at the needle. The needle moved just a little bit because we are further away from the next flight path. So as the GPS updated the next flight leg on the GPS, the needle was also updated. And remember what I told you for HSIs? We want to put in that HSI heading of 232 to the next point holds in there, because we will get confused if we don't. I'll show you exactly what's going to happen in a few seconds as soon as we're established on our 232 heading to holds. Okay, we're established on the 232 heading to holds. We're only 0.17 miles away, which is nothing. Let's zoom the GPS out a little bit so we don't look like we're too far out. And let's get rid of the GPS. Now look what's gonna happen. I'm gonna turn the needle to a heading of 183 of what we had before. And the needle will stay centered. Because the heading bug on the HSI has nothing to do with the GPS, it does not affect it. All the needle is reading right now is that it's centered. It doesn't care what heading we put it on. This can confuse the heck out of you, especially if you don't have the GPS in front of you, because the needle is pointing one way and it's staying centered, and you're flying a completely different heading than what's shown on the needle. What's gonna happen is, once it starts getting busy inside the cockpit and you're doing three things at one time, you can get very easily disoriented with a heading bug and the needle pointing in one direction and we're flying in another direction. Next thing you know, you'll fall behind the airplane. If you're in IFR, that disorientation can put you into unusual attitude, and what's even worse, it can put you in an unrecoverable unusual attitude where you crash the airplane or the airplane falls apart from all the stress that is being put on its airframe. So what you want to do, you always want to have your HSI heading bug heading match your flight path heading. So that's about it, guys, as far as HSI GPS navigation goes. Just remember to put in those heading bugs so you don't get disoriented. So thank you guys for taking your time to watch these videos. The